much can a blind and deaf child learn, Miss Sullivan?
I don't know. Does she communicate with you at all?
Oh, well, I always know what she wants, if that's what you mean.
No, you don't. All anybody knows is that if you give Helen a piece of candy, she'll be quiet for a while. Can you teach her to sit still, Miss Sullivan?
I'd have to teach her language first.
Language? If she doesn't know words, how could she know why you want her to sit still?
Miss Sullivan, perhaps you were misled as to Helen's condition. She can neither see nor hear.
But if it is her senses that are impaired and not her mind, she must have language. Language is more important to the mind than light is to the eye.
But how will you teach her if you can't talk to her?
Anyway, I can.
We are going to do everything that we can to help you. I don't want you to think of us as strangers, Miss Annie.
Those are mine. Then, Helen, doll will be your first word. It's as good as any. D. O. L. L. Doll. Doll. It has a name. D. O. L.
Thank you, Henry. Thank you, Puss. So what was that? Some sort of game?
It's an alphabet for the deaf. Each letter has a sign. D, O, L, L. Doll. First, she will learn to imitate. D, O.
Oh, she can imitate things, all right. Like a regular little monkey.
A bright little monkey. T?
I think she wants her doll back.
She can have it back when she spells it.
She has no idea what words even are. How can she spell them?
If her fingers learn the letters now, then maybe someday her brain will learn that they have a meaning.
Did you make up this alphabet?
Me? No. Spanish monks under a vow of silence, which, Mr. James, I wish you would take. D, A, K, E, cake, C, A, K, E, very good, cake. D, O, L, L. D, O, L. Very good, Helen. Very good. Good first lesson. Very well done. Very well done.
Girl.
Ellen. Mm. Oh.
She was bright. She's the brightest one in this house.
Morning. I hope you've settled in comfortably, Miss Sullivan.
Thank you, Captain. I have.
Please help yourself.
Miss Annie, if there is ever anything that you need, please let us know.
Tobacco price is up, Father. We should earn a nice profit this year for a change.
Used to be a man who'd make a good living running a farm.
Well, perhaps if you'd leave your pet newspaper and come show me my business, we can make some real money.
Not in front of Miss Sullivan.
Why not in front of Miss Sullivan?
Miss Annie, Helen is used to helping herself from our plates.
I'm afraid I'm not used to it.
No, of course not.
Oh!
Viney, please bring Miss Sullivan another plate.
There's nothing wrong with my plate, Captain, only that Helen's hands don't belong in it.
Well, one plate is hardly worth spoiling our breakfast over.
You see, she's just going to keep trying until she gets away.
I must insist that you let the girl go. Thank you.
Oh!
Oh, look, now she's hurt herself.
No, she hasn't. I know a tantrum when I see one. And a badly spoiled child.
Miss Sullivan.
Please show some pity.
For this kind of behavior. Pity's the one thing she doesn't need. The whole house waits on her hand and foot.
Yeah, yeah.
You stay out of this.
Letting Helen have her own way, it's really such a small thing.
Small? It seems you've all decided it's easier to feel sorry for Helen than to teach her how to behave.
Well, I've not seen that you've taught her anything yet, Miss Sullivan.
Quite right, Captain. Well observed. I'll start right now if you leave the room.
Leave the room?
Yes, please, Captain. Right now, if you leave the room.
Miss Sullivan,
if you're not willing to stand up to one tantrum, I cannot teach her anything. Mrs. Keller, you asked if there was anything I needed.
Yes, but
I need to be alone with Helen. Right now.
Miss Sullivan?
Oh, Captain. James? Captain, may I speak with you outside?
Give us a moment, please.
This is absurd.
Arthur, I am sure that she is only trying to do what is best.
I will not have my house turned into a circus. Unless there is a change in attitude, Miss Sullivan is dismissed.
Arthur, and then what hope do we have for Helen?
No less than we had before. And then perhaps we can regain some quiet.
Why is it so hard to understand? Horse. Horse. eats. Apple. Such a lady. She'd rather starve than eat without a spoon.
You have taught her so much in a week and a half.
It's not enough. Obedience is not enough. She knows so many words. If only she knew what they meant.
And how will she learn?
The way a bird learns to use its wings, it has to come.
But how, Miss Annie?
I need more. G. Egg. The word is the thing. It has a name. Bird. The bird is coming out of its shell, Helen. You come out too. Thank you.
keys. She wants the keys.
Love, Helen.